Hi friends, it's me Priya Prasad. Welcome back. Welcome to the world of economics. Hope that you all are fine, safe and happy. Today I am going to explain production possibility curve. It is also known as production possibility curve, frontier or what is boundary. Okay, then it is very important topic in microeconomics. Please don't try to miss this video. Please try to support my channel, subscribe my channel, try to share my videos with your friends. Okay, then come, let's learn together, let's begin the class. Production possibility curves or production possibility frontier or boundary. Okay, then it is showing alternative production possibilities of two commodities open to an economy. Alternative production possibilities of two commodities open to an economy. Okay, we already know that our resources are scarce or limited, so we have to utilize our resources in an efficient manner. Okay, otherwise we will not produce more units of commodities, so we will not attain what is economic growth. So in order to produce more units of one commodity, we have to sacrifice or we have to curtail the production of some units of another commodity. Okay, assume that there are two commodities are produced in an economy. So in order to produce more units of one commodity, we have to curtail or we have to sacrifice the production of another commodity. What is the reason behind that? We have limited resources only. With that limited resources, we have to do like this in order to produce what is maximum output. Okay, with limited resources, in order to produce maximum output with limited resources. So production possibility curve explains or expresses what is alternative production possibilities of two commodities open to an economy. Are all the possible options of output for two products that can be produced using the given factors of production. All the possible options of output for two products that can be produced using the given factors of production. Then one of the important thing is here, what is maximum utilization of available resources. We have to use our resources maximum in an efficient manner, so we can attain economic growth. Got it? So we can produce maximum amount of output. Got it? That is production possibility curve. Okay, then now we can explain table and a diagram. Then here it is the production possibility table. Here in the first column, PP, production possibilities, various alternative production possibilities available to an economy. Then here we are trying to assume that there are only two commodities, which are they? Cloth and wheat. Okay, for example, we are taking two commodities, production of two commodities, cloth and wheat. Okay, see, in the first combination, or in the first possibility A, then that country or economy produce 0 units of cloth and 15 units of what is wheat. So the production of wheat is maximum. So in order to produce one commodity maximum, then another commodity will be minimum or least. Nothing will be there, another commodity. Okay, because we already know that in order to produce one commodity in more units, we have to sacrifice the production of another commodity. That's why. Okay, so cloth is here 0 and wheat is 15. The maximum wheat is here. In the combination B or in the possibility B, cloth, 1 units of cloth is produced and 14 units of wheat. So in order to produce 1 unit of cloth, that country or economy sacrificed 1 unit of what is wheat. Okay, curtailed from 15 to 14. Got it? Again, in the possibility C, 2 units of cloth produced. For that, what is 2 units of wheat, what is sacrificed? Production of 2 units of wheat has sacrificed in order to produce 1 more units of what unit of what is cloth. Okay, like that it will go like this. Okay, for 3 units of cloth, 9 units of wheat. For 4 units of cloth, 5 units of wheat. For 5 units of what is maximum, here it is a maximum of cloth 5 units and wheat is nothing here. So in order to produce one commodity maximum, another commodity will be what is 0. Got it? Okay, that is this table. Then, and this is our diagram, PPC, production possibility curve. In this diagram, x-axis represents or measures clothes in meter and y-axis represents wheat in kilogram. And PP is our production possibility curve and it is concave shape. It has what is concave shape. Okay. Here in the first stage, in the first possibility, what is 15 units of wheat is produced, and for in that place 0 units of cloth. Okay, for 15 units of wheat, 0 units of cloth. Then for 14 units of wheat and 1 units of cloth. 12 units of what is wheat, 2 units of cloth. Okay, in order to produce one more unit of cloth, then 2 units of wheat has sacrificed. Okay, then like this it will go. For maximum of cloth 5, okay, then there is what is 0, wheat is 0 only. Maximum, for maximum cloth wheat is here what is 0 only. Okay, this is production possibility curve. So that country can utilize maximum what is available resources, maximum utilization of available resources, okay, in order to produce more commodities. Then various alternative combinations or possibilities of production of two commodities, that is production possibility. Okay, like this it will go. Got it? One more time, repeat the video. One more thing is here, Pareto efficiency. What is Pareto efficiency? This related to Italian economist Wilfredo Pareto. It is related to Italian economist Wilfredo Pareto. According to him, beneath the point, that inside, if any point inside the production possibility curve, that is indicating inefficiency of an economy, that is indicating inefficiency of an economy, because they are not trying to utilize their resources in an efficient manner. That's why they cannot produce maximum amount of output. Okay, see, in this production possibility curve PP, here U is the point inside the point, QRS, it is the these are the different production possibilities. These are efficient, but this point, this is U, is inefficient. And what is the reason behind that? If any point inside the production possibility curve, inside the production possibility curve, that is indicating inefficiency of a country, or they are not trying to utilize their resources in an efficient manner. That is explained by whom? Wilfredo Pareto, that is Pareto efficiency. Okay, okay, then next one, transformation, upward shift of production possibility curve, right hand shift or upward, right hand side shift or upward shift of production possibility curve. Okay, now that is indicating economic growth of an economy, economic growth. There is economic growth in that situation. What is the reason behind that? If the production possibility curve shifts from PP to P1, here it is our initial production possibility PP, P1, right hand side, the possibilities increased, means the volume of output increased. Okay, so that is indicating economic growth or more efficiency, or that country is trying to use their resources in an efficient manner. That country is trying to use their scarce resources in an efficient manner. So right hand side shift or upward shift of production possibility curve is indicating economic growth, that economy can produce more units of commodities with the available resources. So they are trying to use their resources, or they are using their resources in an efficient manner. Maximum they are utilizing, okay, with minimum cost. Okay, that is transformation. Okay, this much only this video. Please try to repeat this video, and if there any doubt or suggestion, let me know right down in the comment box. Okay, see you in the next video. Thank you, thanks a lot, take care, bye.